story is told of a little girl who has just suffered loss, something that's very important to her, 5-year-old girl. And her dad is concerned how she will react to that. And so he went upstairs and came to a room outside and was looking at what she's doing. He was pleasantly surprised to see the little girl kneeling beside her bed and being in a posture of prayer such as this. And so he puts his ear nearer to try to listen to what she is praying. What is it that she will ask God for? And the little girl, 5-year-old girl, said, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, N, Z. And he prays that over and over and over again. Daddy was puzzled. After the prayer, he went to her and says, Dear, why do you say A, B, C, D, E, F, G when you're bowed down in such a posture? She says, I'm praying to God. Huh? Praying to God? Yes, I pray to God. I didn't know what to say, but I figured that God is smart enough to figure what I need. And so I gave him my words, my letters, and he frames it for me. I'm not suggesting we pray like that. Please don't. We have a responsibility to learn the heart of God, to learn the principles of God, to grow in the grace and knowledge of God. We are responsible to learn about prayer. Yet at the same time, sometimes words just ain't enough. Sometimes words just fail us. Sometimes we do not know what we ought to pray for as we ought. We can be rejoicing that the Spirit helps us. I picture it also like this. This may not be a very accurate illustration, but it's somewhat helps. Suppose you have a photocopying machine that broke down in the office, and you are the only one who is there to take care of it. You call up the office, the manufacturer, and say, hey, this photocopying machine doesn't work. It seems to be jammed. It seems to not be functioning well. Can you help me? The guy asks you, can you open this casing, go to that roller, look at the button? He says, I don't know what you're talking about. No. Go to check that. Look at the motherboard or the fatherboard or the son or the what board. Check all those things and tell me. And you struggle over the phone because you do not know what these things are. You have no language to describe. Then you, in your frustration, say, can you send someone to help me? The technician comes. He opens the casing, looks at the rollers, check the buttons just like you did, and he makes a phone call back to the office. Hey, Taukeya, this is what I need. Button 313, whatever he says. And within a few seconds, Tauke says, all right, I understand. We are going to send the parts to you right now. Sometimes we do not know what to, we don't even know what's happening. We don't know how to say it. The Holy Spirit knows the mind of God, knows the will of God. And even when we ask wrongly, He perfects it in His mercy. So this is the great encouragement to prayer. Prayer is the desires, the desperations, the dependences in your heart. The Spirit takes those things and like a vehicle, He uses it to carry His intercession to the throne of God. He uses your groanings. He uses your desires. He uses your dependences and your desperations as vehicles to carry the intercessions to the throne of God. That's what He does. And He prays for you, not against you.